Senator Stein, for what purpose do you ask?
See if the speaker will yield to the question.
I will yield.
Is it your intention and the intention of this chamber to reopen Dix Hospital?
There is no intent in this bill other than to reopen a mental institution on that property. That is correct.
Follow up.
Senator Hill.
I yield.
Are you familiar with the Healing Place?
I am not.
Follow up.
Senator Hill.
I yield.
Do you know how much mental health treatment is done on Dix property today?
I would provide that most of the administration for mental health services all across the state is done on the Dixie property at this time.
To debate the bill.
Senator Stein has the floor to debate the bill.
Currently, 10 acres is dedicated to mental health today. The Healing Place of Wake County provides mental health treatment to people. Otherwise, there are no mental health treatment being provided on Dix property. The hospital has been closed. A lot of people have issues about that being closed, but state moved into Butler, and that's where mental health, the hospital is today. You all don't intend to open up the hospital again. Cost would be tens of millions of dollars. That hospital is ancient. So to say that this is about mental health is a farce. It isn't about mental health. This is about a lease that you didn't like because it was signed by a governor you didn't like with a city you don't like. That's what this is about. If y'all care about mental health, you had an opportunity in the first week of the session to do something about it. I ran the net present value of the dollar amount that Senator Heiss said this land is worth versus what the lease amount is. You know what the annual difference is? It's $1.5 million a year. Now, $1.5 million, that's not insubstantial. But in the scope of the Medicaid budget, which is over $3 billion with a B, not an M, it is a drop in the bucket. Over this biennium, you all rejected $2.5 billion in 100% federally funded Medicaid dollars, 45 to 50% of which goes to mental health treatment, substance abuse, and developmental disabilities. So let's do the math on that. $1.25 billion at no cost to the North Carolina taxpayer for mental health in North Carolina right now versus $1.5 million over the life of this loan. And by the way, you're not going to get that $1.5 million over the life of the loan because what you've done is you've reduced the land that's suitable to the lease. As Senator Hunt noted in committee, it's a floodplain. It is a former landfill site. It is not the nice property of Dix. So even if you've got a fair market value on that, it will not be substantially more than what the $500,000 that goes from the city to the state for mental health under the current lease. So we are talking hundreds of thousands a year when you all forego $1 billion this year for mental health. Do not make this about mental health because it isn't.
Senator Hines, what purpose do you ask?
Ask Speaker question.
Senator Hill for a question.
I do.
Senator Stein, are you aware of the federal designation of an Institute of Mental Disease or an IMD?
I am not.
Follow up.
You yield for another question, Senator.
Would you also be aware that under what the federal government, Dorothea Dix Hospitals and others, that Medicaid funding cannot be used, regardless of the expansion or otherwise, to provide for services for any individual in an institution or institute of mental disease?
I am aware of that, but that doesn't mean it can't go for mental health purposes. To think that the only way to deliver mental health care to people in North Carolina is in an institution is a backward way of thinking about mental health treatment.